Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord rises upon you. This was our theme for Assembly 2016, and I think God's glory did rise upon us. We are most alive and most us when we are learning to live in the flaming reality of the presence of Jesus. I'm convinced that this was part of what God did for us at Assembly 2016. There were incredible moments of fresh visitation by the power of the Holy Spirit. I don't think I've ever been to an assembly where I've seen hundreds of people come forward with a heart of just seeking God and seeking to see more of His presence and more of His power manifest in our life and, yes, in our movement. I want to take just a few moments to talk with you about a decision that was made at Assembly 2016. In particular, the decision that was made around women serving as senior pastor. We used the discernment process, and it provided everyone with an opportunity to hear from God and to speak into this issue. And God very clearly spoke to us and communicated that no matter which way the decision went, He wanted us to focus on fierce unity, a commitment to living together and serving together to see the nations of the world reached for Jesus Christ. Let's remain on mission together. The question that we were seeking to get some response to was this: will the Christian Missionary Alliance in Canada permit churches who by two-thirds majority vote of the members present at a duly called meeting of the membership have affirmed to have women to serve on the board to call a woman to serve as senior pastor in consultation with the district superintendent? It's very important that we understand the scope of that question. The decision made regarding women as senior pastor was a permission-giving affirmation for churches with women already serving on their elders' boards and for churches who might move in this direction in the future. Currently, we have around 70 churches out of 440 churches with women serving on their elders' board. Now, this decision doesn't obligate such churches to move towards seeing a woman serve as a senior pastor, but it provides the opportunity for that. We want to make sure that our churches have great freedom in being able to choose the leaders that God wants them to choose. We want to encourage you in your local church to be men and women of great faith in these days of amazing opportunities. I know that decisions like this can be challenging for us as a denomination, but I believe that the word of the Lord to us as a denominational family is that we need to lock arms. That we really do need to stand together, that we need to have a fresh vision for reaching the nations of the world. So as your president, I would embrace you. I would tell you again that I love you and that it's a thrill to serve you and that truly we as a movement are better together. We are stronger as we keep listening and talking to each other. May God empower us. May God give us fresh courage. May God engage us in renewed risk as we seek to reach the nations of the world for His glory.